relative. I mean, I can tell you from my own personal experience that sometimes there are blood relatives you don't want to have anything to do with.
If you don't like giving out money for dates or for sex, what about giving it to the government?
Giving it to the government?
Your money.
Oh, I don't like that.
Yeah, no one probably does.
No. No, I mean, I obviously pay my taxes and I do what I'm required to do, but I also have a good accountant. I try not to pay any more than I have to. And I try to invest sensibly, of course. But I will also say that people who don't spend money on marriage and going to TJ Maxx and going to the mall all the time, they're more likely to own more real estate, more likely to own stocks and bonds and mutual funds and what have you, and less likely to own junk they're going to throw out in a few years or give to Goodwill, closets full of shoes that never get worn more than a few times, or T-shirts that look cute in 1989.
You know, all the pack rats that I know are men. Men are bigger pack rats.
I just think you notice them because they are men, and men are to be criticized and downgraded all the time. But believe me, women are pack rats. I was with a woman who had 100 pairs of sneakers.
Different. That is a little ridiculous.
Colors.
But I do think that the recession has made people be a little bit less materialistic. I know for myself, well, living in New York, I don't even want to buy any heels because you don't wear them because the streets will ruin them and it's not comfortable. But also, you got to think, what's the future going to be like? Should I save to be able to eat or buy shoes?
And ironically, the recession has actually done a lot of really good things for people's sex lives. This has been a lot of the recent research. The people are staying in more. There's encouraging of finding ways to connect that don't require as much money. And it's
another good excuse for men not to spend money on women, saying, hey, the recession, come on. Who's got money for going out to dinner?
You know, I'm
not going to argue with you that there is a benefit to children to be married. There's just no benefit to men. For example, I've talked to men. I spoke to men specifically who have been good friends of mine who have gotten a woman pregnant. And they're thinking about getting married to her. And I say, don't do that. Because if you do, you'll have to pay alimony and child support. Just pay child support. Pay your child support. Be a good man. Pay your child support. But don't marry her, because then you're going to have to pay her in addition to child support.
Or don't date gold diggers. Go after women who aren't wowed by the money.
These are not necessarily gold diggers. Some of these people are in the lowest economic strata of life. Not gold diggers.
A gold digger is a gold digger, regardless of where they come from. A woman who's just seeking money can come from anywhere.
A woman who wants to get married is seeking money. Because that is why people get married.
There's a variety of reasons people get married. They get married for religious ones, for romantic ones, for financial reasons.
What about women who refuse to sign a prenuptial agreement? What would you say they're getting married for?
That's entirely their own personal reason.
So
it could be.
You will, just in case your boyfriend is watching, you will sign a prenuptial agreement if he asks you to?
We don't have any money, but sure. I mean, that's not the point to me. I think a prenuptial agreement.
But what if
you're starting out even, then pretty much you're putting the work into the marriage together. And anything that someone may acquire through the time that you've been together probably should be half of yours.
Not necessarily.
If it's stuff beforehand, like I have a friend who
Jackson and my wife's name is Debbie Rowe, who did not create the Michael Jackson empire, who did not create any of the songs or the music videos, why should Debbie Rowe get half of everything Michael Jackson makes?
I'm just saying that I understand that. I understand a prenup for people who, like my friend, one of my friends has had to have her husband sign one because she basically has like $1 million trust fund. So if she gets divorced, the husband isn't going to get that because that's her family's. And then
if I'm married and I invent the perfect peeler and I get Billy Mays come back from the grave and start pitching this on TV and I make $1 billion. Why should my wife get half
if you guys both went into the marriage, say you both make $100,000, and the wife has put in 13 years of marriage, just throwing that number out there. And then all of a sudden, you come up with an invention, and you made it. She still could has been with you for 13 years, and maybe didn't go out on her own and create her own idea because she was married.
Or she may have nagged me the whole time and said, what are you doing in the garage? What are you working on out there? Stop. Come inside. What are you doing? I have been with women who, in my career, have tried to hinder my career. Stop me from going on the road. Stop me from doing vulgarity on the radio, whatever. They have tried to hinder my progress, not help it. Why should they get half of everything I earn?
There are post-snaps, too, I believe.
Well, and good luck getting someone to sign after they're married and they've got you where they want you.
We're also discussing a very specific type of marriage. Most people don't make millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars.
You don't have to
the vast majority
of
people
this
also...
This is a real problem that people keep thinking the prenups are only for millionaires. Everybody should have a prenup, and here's why everybody should have one. It is because everybody should have the conversation about what would happen if this marriage ends.
Well, that's the whole point of a marriage versus like a let's move in together. I think you don't have to get married. I'm not a big advocate. I'm not telling everybody to get married, but if you decide to, that's your decision. That's on you. If you want a prenup,
so if
also
you find never get, let me understand.
But what I'm saying is if you enter a marriage, you should intend for it to be together. Forever. That's the intention. If you don't want to be together forever,
I'm going to tell you, no one's making you get married. I have the answer. You know, when I get in my car, when I get back to Los Angeles, and I start the engine, I am not planning on having a car accident. But I'll tell you, I've got car insurance, because it might happen. And by the way, the odds of having an accident are much lower than the odds of getting divorced. So I get in my car, assuming I'm not going to have an accident. I'm assuming I'm not going to be a quadriplegic by the time I get to point B. Okay.
See,
but just in case, I've got insurance. And that's what a prenuptial agreement is. It's insurance.
What if you don't have anything going into the marriage? Like you're saying, a lot of people in this country...
So why would people assume they're going to be losers the rest of their lives?
I don't think that that's in any way the point. The point is that you're supposed to be forming some sort of partnership. Again, I think the difference is here, you're looking at everybody as an individual business entity looking out for their own best interest.
Which they should.
Incredible narcissism at its worst.
It has nothing to do with narcissism. It has to do with pragmatism.
It's just one particular way of a partnership. Two people joining together.
Narcissism is believing you're going to stay together with the same person and they're not going to rob off with someone else.
That's optimism. Narcissism is I want what I want and I'm going to get it at the most convenient time for the least cost that I possibly have to pay for I deserve it.
Women are not doing the same thing that women are not bragging that they're dating a doctor or dating a lawyer, which, by the way, right downstairs on 6th Avenue, you go over to Del Frisco's tonight to the bar, you're going to find women looking to be doctors and lawyers in the bar.
Well, now, are you cool with any woman that you meet? Are you just sort of like, hey, I know you want me for my money. There's never going to be any romance.
Well, I know they're not going to get the money, so what do I care? Ever been with a guy who only wants you for your looks? Tell the truth.
You know what? I've been married for 4 years.
Ever
and
been with a man?
I'm happily. Well, probably. I'm
who
sure.
Who only wanted you for your looks?
I'm sure, but I'm
were you
actually
offended?
Kind of a cool person.
Were you offended?
You should probably be respected
for
that as well.
They end up liking me because I actually am a nice, cool, caring person who's not
That's
after
great.
Anyone for...